The Philippine ICT Department not taking the removal of their confidential funds lightly. ICT Secretary Ivan Uy says this sends a wrong message to cyber criminals targeting the Philippines. He also warns of more cyber attacks if government won't provide more funding to improve the country's cyber defenses.
You know, we're reallocating it to agencies that's guarding the West Philippine Sea. That is just one portion of our physical borders. What about our cyber borders? You already saw how our PhilHealth was attacked. And there will be more of these in the coming days, coming weeks, and coming years. What about our energy grid? What about our telecommunications? What about our transportation? You saw when the airport shut down for one day, what chaos it created. There will be more of those that will happen because we have no cyber security budget to prevent those from happening.
Uy now calls on the Senate to consider restoring the 300 million peso confidential fund of the agency.
It's going to be an appeal on our part because it sends a very wrong signal to the rest of the world. While cyber threats and cyber criminals are increasing and they're becoming more sophisticated and they have more funds actually to do so, the Philippines going against the tide of the rest of the world.
The Philippine Senate also vows to scrutinize proposed confidential funds of civilian agencies. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel believes the Office of the President must also be stripped of secret funds. President Marcos's office was spared by Congress as it still retains over 4 billion pesos in confidential and intelligence funds next year. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva, meanwhile, assures the public they will scrutinize the budget to ensure it will be polished before passing. For Senator Sonny Angara, only agencies with defined fund spending will be considered for next year's confidential funds allocation.
I think that's the rule of budgeting. You show that you use the funds properly, nagastos mo sa tamang panahon, sa tamang paraan, at saka sa tamang mga layunin, at dun mo makikita, dun yung pamantayan ng Kongreso sa pag-alat ng mga budget. We discuss it usually in caucus and then we reach a consensus para sa floor medyo smooth sailing na yung decision. Nagkaisa na kumbaga dun sa napag-usapang decision.
President Marcos declares October 30 a non-working holiday. This is to allow Filipinos to cast their votes in the village and youth council polls on that day. According to the Commission on Elections, about a million candidates across the country are vying for some 600,000 positions in the upcoming polls. The Philippine Agriculture Department mulls importing pork amid a possible shortage of the meat in time for the holiday season. Now, the agency is projecting a 10-day supply shortfall in the fourth quarter as cases of African swine fever rise. At least 19 provinces in the country have recorded cases of ASF. The DA is also checking the need to impose a suggested retail price for pork if they observe price manipulation. Agricultural group SINAG, not keen on government's importation plan, citing ample supply of pork in cold storages across the country. Importers also saying even if the imports were made today, the order won't arrive until January next year.
Kapag kukulangin tayo ng local na pork, tataas nila ang presyo ng local pork. Kapag tumaas ang presyo ng local pork, hihina ang consumption. And then the market either lilipat sila sa imported o kung ayaw pa nila sa imported, lilipat sila sa local na manok o hindi muna sila kakain ng baboy.
The Philippine Transportation Chief calls for a full-blown investigation over possible corruption inside the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, as well as his own agency, the Transportation Department. Secretary Jaime Bautista says he wants to get the side first of the suspended LTFRB Chairman Teofilo Guadis III. Bautista also wants a whistleblower, Guadis's former aide, Jeffrey Tumbado, investigated for his alleged involvement in corruption at the agency. Despite the allegations, Bautista says their projects, including the contested PUV modernization program, that's going to push through. He also believes the planned nationwide strike by jeepney operators on October 16 will not push through. Global messaging app Viber aims to help MSMEs scale up with its new offering. Our very own Jackie Pascual also tells us the company is looking to finally launch Viber Pay by next year.
Messaging app Viber launched its business account for small businesses in the Philippines. Viber earlier made the service available for large companies, and now it wants to expand its reach to small and medium enterprises or SMEs, which comprise majority of businesses in the country.
Our aim is to help these businesses to grow, a micro business to become a small business to become a medium business, and why not a medium business become a large business.
SMEs or anyone who wants to sell goods can open a business account on the app where they can showcase their products and services. Customers can search for the store and message the shop for orders or inquiries. In the future, Viber said it plans to roll out other services such as possible partnerships with logistics companies and add the in-app payment feature Viber Pay, which may be launched in the Philippines next year.
Make sure that it's the right time to launch with the right product fit for the users and the market itself. You can see the synergy. It's very clear that Viber Pay will be part of the benefits for this whole ecosystem.
At the recent opening of the Cybersecurity Month, some experts warn of potential scams in online shopping, with fraudsters victimizing customers or the business itself.
Cybercrime that we're facing for businesses. And this is whether you're a multinational company, a big, large enterprise here in the Philippines, and even the small to medium enterprises.
They try to ride the monthly promo cycles of Lazada, Shopee, Amazon even. No? You have the upcoming 10-10. No? After that, it's 11-11, 12-12. We see fraud to tend to scale up.
But Viber assured the public that the platform is secure.
We have our built-in algorithm to ensure that those numbers that can be of spam nature or scam nature, we will do the necessary to block. Second things, we are also checking against the companies. For example, they can't fake another established company by the account.
Viber says it has a 71% market share in the Philippines, one of its largest markets globally, and it is confident of staying on top in the country. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.